Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge, and in today's video, I have 7 tips for you to help you edit faster in Final Cut Pro. There's a lot of videos out there on how you can speed up the app itself, but today, I'm going to focus more on what you can do to edit more efficiently, therefore faster. We'll get into it right after a quick message from the sponsor of this video, Envato Elements. Whether you edit videos for a living or it's just a hobby, a subscription to Envato Elements could be a game changer. It's an all-in-one subscription service that gives you access to over 56 million digital assets. You get unlimited downloads of stock video, royalty-free music and sound effects, video templates, graphic templates, custom fonts, and so much more. And new items are added every week. Everything Envato Elements has to offer is included for one low monthly fee. This is super helpful if you're trying to grow your business or your YouTube channel and don't have an unlimited budget. Click the link in the video description and see how Envato Elements can help you make better videos. We all know you can edit faster by learning and using keyboard shortcuts. I'm going to go a little deeper and talk about custom keyboard shortcuts. If there's something you do all the time, like blading a clip for example, even if you already use the default keyboard shortcut Command-B, you can save quite a bit of time by making this a one-key shortcut. Open the Commands pop-up in Final Cut Pro and select Customize. You can't edit the default command set, so first thing you need to do is make a copy of it. Next, select the B key on the virtual keyboard, and on the right-hand side, you see all the assigned shortcuts. Pressing B with no modifier is assigned to select the blade tool. I hardly ever use this, so to me, it would make much more sense swapping these two around. I'll drag the blade tool command down here to one of these empty spots, drag up blade to no modifier, bring the blade tool up to the command modifier spot, and drag the duplicate off to the side to remove it. I'll also drag the blade all command to option B. Now, when I need to blade my clip, instead of having to press two keys, I only have to press one. This may not seem like a big deal, but trust me, it'll save you a lot of time. Tip number two is organizing your workspace. Depending on what stage of your project you're on, there are certain elements you need to see in your Final Cut window, and some are just a distraction. Using workspaces can really help with this. Final Cut Pro has 3 built-in workspaces. To switch between them, select Window and Workspace. Here you have the option of using the default workspace, one for organizing your media, and one for color and effects. You can also make your own space and save it to a custom preset. While we're on the topic of eliminating distractions, tip 3 is rejecting clips. If you have clips in your media browser you know you're not going to use, but can't delete them, you can reject these clips and hide them from your media browser. For example, when I record my A-roll, I record my video and audio separately, then sync them after import. I know I'm not going to use these clips, but I can't delete them because I need them for my synced clip. What I can do is select these clips and press delete to reject them. Now, if I select hide rejected from the view dropdown, all the clips I marked as rejected are gone. But they're not really gone, just hidden. The fourth tip I have for you today is placing your most used titles and effects into a separate category. This is especially useful if you download third-party plugins with tons of presets. Select the title or effect you keep going back to, right-click on it, and select Open in Motion. Next, from the menu bar, select File and Save As. Give it a name. And from the category dropdown, select New Category. Name this category, click Create, and publish it. Now, instead of scrolling through all your titles trying to find the one you want, you just select your most used category, and your title is right there. Tip number 5 is the keyboard shortcut Shift Command V. What this does is paste the attributes from a copied clip. So, if you have one clip and you added some effects to it, or changed it in any way, and you need the same effects added to another clip, you just select the clip and press Command-C to copy it. Now, if you select another clip and press Shift-Command-V, a Paste Attributes window pops up. Select the attributes you want to transfer to this clip, and press Paste to apply all these attributes to the selected clip. This can be a huge time saver. And while we're on this topic, if you have a certain effect or a set of effects, like a color grade you apply to all your clips across multiple projects or even libraries, you can save these as an effects preset. Select the clip that has the adjustments applied to it, and in the video inspector, at the bottom, click the Save Effects Preset button. Select the attributes you want to save in this preset, Give it a name, select the category you want to save it in, and click the Save button. Next time you need to apply these same effects to a clip, just select it from the effects browser and drag and drop it onto your clip. Easy and can save you a ton of time. Last topic I want to talk about today is custom audio folders. If you have a library of royalty-free music and sound effects you use for your videos, you can have these readily available in your Final Cut Pro's audio sidebar. To add your music, select the folder with all your music and sound effects, right-click on it, and select Make Alias. Drag this folder out to your desktop. Next, press Shift-Command-C to open the computer window, select your system drive, Library, Audio, Apple Loops, Apple, and Final Cut Pro Sound Effects. Drag your folder shortcut into this location and remove Alias from the name. Now, when you need to access your sound effects in Final Cut Pro, go into your audio sidebar, select Sound Effects, and pick your custom audio folder from the drop-down menu. The nice thing about doing it this way, instead of importing your folder into Final Cut Pro, is if you download and add more tracks to this folder, they automatically show up in Final Cut Pro. I hope you found at least one of these tips helpful. If you did, let me know by hitting the like button or in the comments below. And a huge thank you to Envato Elements for making videos like this possible. If you're looking for a way to support my channel and get access to millions of digital assets, consider subscribing to Envato Elements. For every one of you that signs up, I get a small fee. So thank you for your support. I'll see you back here next week.